The controversial Cyber Intelligence Sharing and Protection Act has been approved by the House of Representatives. One of the congressmen evoked Monday's deadly bombings in Boston as a reason to pass it. Let's get some more details on this, shall we, and talk to RT America's website producer, Andrew Blake. He's been closely following the debates over the bill. Hi there, Andrew. This bill seems in a bit of limbo at the moment, doesn't it? What are the chances that it's actually going to get through or be blocked? Which way is it going to go?
Okay, well, you know, it did pass the House today, and it's going to have to move on to the Senate. And should these U.S. senators agree to advance it like the House did today and send it over to the White House, it's then up to President Obama to ink his name to it. And then from there, we have CISPA. However, just earlier this week, top aides for the White House actually said that we will recommend the president veto this legislation. So should it pass the Senate, there is this warning that the president will not sign it and he'll actually completely reject it. But we have to keep in mind this is a president who has said before, or his aides have said before, that they will do one thing and have done another. You don't have to look any further than the National Defense Authorization Act. The NDAA passed in late 2011. In that case, the president said he would veto it, and sure enough, he signed it into law. So there is a chance that these threats are meaningless and this whole thing is moot, but we're really going to have to see what happens in the Senate before we can actually take it from there.
Andrew, remind our viewers, many of which aren't in America, why this act is causing so much controversy.
So the CISPA, the Cyber Sharing Intelligence, I'm sorry, the Cyber Intelligence Sharing and Protection Act, has come under a lot of criticism by its opponents because they say that it does more than what the authors say it does. Now, the authors of CISPA, they say that this bill will let businesses, private companies, Google, Facebook, and any internet provider, these companies will be encouraged to share information with the federal government that will be used to track down, monitor, and curb cyber attacks aimed at the United States computers. Now, in theory, yes, it would do that. CISPA would allow the government to have access to this information, and it would remove liability from these companies. But at the same time, critics say that it puts too much of Americans' privacy at risk and that the right safeguards aren't there. So, in turn, people would be sacrificing their privacy for a little bit of security, and the opponents of the bill say that the balance just hasn't been struck and it needs to go back, and lawmakers need to try again to find a legislation that will handle these cybersecurity concerns while also making American people feel like they are at ease and that their communications will not be targeted.
Of course, the supporters of the bill wasting no time in mentioning the Boston bombings as a reason to pass the bill. Do they have a fair point?
It was almost comical because when the bill was introduced back in February, I believe, when it was introduced for the second time, Representative Ruppersberger, one of the authors of the bill, he said, we can't have another 9/11. We can't have another terrorist attack. But if we do, we will pass any law that needs to happen. Sure enough, just a few hours ago, another congressman, I believe it was Representative McCall, not certain there. The whole story is on rt.com/USA. But another congressman, he actually got up and said, well, look at what happened in Boston. These were bombs. Sure, they weren't digital bombs, but the next ones will be digital bombs. So we need to come together for the sake of national security and do something. And that's exactly why a lot of people have problems with this bill, because the people who are touting it, the people who are writing it, are people that don't really understand these cybersecurity concerns. Another lawmaker actually said that WikiLeaks was a hacking group and they're hacking the United States infrastructure. This is also like an unfounded claim. So there's a lot of concern over who is coming up with this bill, who is supporting it, and what they actually know about cybersecurity. The incident this morning saying that Boston would be reason enough to pass a cybersecurity bill is laughable to many people.
We're following it closely. Thanks for your input as well, RT America's web producer Andrew Blake on RT there.